This is an old HP EliteDesk 800 G2 SFF. It is relatively small and compact, equipped with an i7 Intel processor, and in combination with the tool I'm about to mention, it makes for a pretty cool and cost-effective home server package. The tool I'm referring to is ZimaOS, which is still in the beta, and I will briefly introduce it today. With your questions and comments, I will make a more detailed video in the coming weeks. But one thing I can already spoiler is that this HomeOS or Homeserver OS is really, really absurd, easy and good. But before I dive into ZimaOS, let's quickly go over the hardware. The base is the HP EliteDesk 800 G2 SFF with an Intel i7-6700. For some light graphic task, I choose the Nvidia Quadro P400, which fits perfectly into the case. I might swap it out later for an Nvidia Tesla P4 with 8GB. 4TB Seagate HDD for shares, 16GB DDR4 RAM and an SSD for ZimaOS. An M.2, which my PC doesn't support, could be used as a cache within ZimaOS. The installation is super easy. Just search for ZimaOS on Google, head directly to GitHub, download the image from the latest releases, launch Balana Etcher, select the image, choose the SSD, flash the image onto it, connect the SSD to the computer, boot up, and you're ready to go. Boom, 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 boom. That's simple. It couldn't be easier. That's already a huge plus. Next, get the IP address of your server and open up your browser, paste it, enter. Set up your user account, enter your name and your password, boom, 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 boom. You're greeted by the interface. How smart is that? It just works. No endless settings, no unnecessary buttons or taskbars, just a sleek UI with essential features. The UI is simple too. On the left side, you can see all the stats related to the server, such as CPU and RAM usage, installed GPUs, and if you install multiple GPUs, they will be displayed here as well. And you will also have an overview of your hard drive status and another widget for the network usage. Higher up, you can create some users, access the settings, or restart the system and check the network's status. What immediately stands out are the great app widgets. ZimaOS comes with an app store, ZFS file system, virtualizations, which I haven't tested yet, peer drop for sharing files similar to airdrop, and a widget that takes you directly to the community website. Since the latest update of ZimaOS 1.2.4, the software supports SSH and additional GPUs and CPUs. So what's the purpose? You can use the system as a network storage or as a base for a home automation with Home Assistant. Initially, I didn't have any specific ideas and I just wanted to try the system out. After a bit of tinkering and tweaking, I realized how easy and user-friendly everything is. Even integrating apps like OpenWeb UI or Stable Diffusion is easier than ever. Just go to the App Store, search for the app you want, click install and start. No need to mess with complicated settings like I do in Unraid Every Time or in Proxmox and TrueNAS. I have spent countless hours researching and testing those systems, so this simplicity is a big and huge plus for me. In addition to AI applications, you can also use ZimaOS as a media server with Plex or Jellyfin. Alternatively, for those who have sleeve of movies at home and want to digitize them, ZimaOS supports Handbrake, which works perfectly. Furthermore, there are other apps like AdGuard, Pyos, ESP Home, Nextcloud or Grafana. I'm really excited to see what other apps will come available in the App Store in the next month. If you have watched this far, please give this video a like and subscribe my channel. Setting up Samba or SMB shares is also quite easy. In the ZimaOS UI, go to Files. Then select the desired folder and click on the three dots. Choose Share Samba. A window will open where you can assign read or write permissions or create new users. If necessary, create a user with a password and click Create. After that, you are ready to use SMB. Simply copy the generated link for Windows or Mac and paste it in your favorite Explorer or Finder. I couldn't resist and just had to test it. The goal was to install my legendary Frankenstein Nvidia Tesla P4 into the small PC and use Open Web UI. After inserting the card, I quickly realized that the motherboard doesn't have an additional fan header. No problem, I quickly installed a YPVM cable on the CPU cooler, started the PC and... yeah, right, no display output. I quickly swapped the position of the cards and... yep, it worked. I strongly suspect that I need to define the video output in the BIOS first, since the P4 only has a virtual video output. So I quickly launched Open Web UI, downloaded the necessary LLM models, and yeah, I was really impressed. Performance? Top notch. At my first impression, I couldn't notice any direct difference from ChatGPT, and I also clearly see from the temperature and load that the card was natively recognized and running without any additional settings. And that is what I'm exactly looking for. Now, let's address a point that's crucial these days: power consumptions. I mentioned earlier that I'm running ZimaOS on an older HP PC. So what about power usage? I should mention upfront that I couldn't find any settings related to the hard drive sleep behavior. And yes, I know, I previously said that too much many settings can be annoying. Additionally, I haven't made any power savings adjustments in the BIOS, none at all. There might be some potential for the improvement here, but overall, I find the power consumption for in such an old PC
is okay. It's okay.
For the standard, it might be even a bit too high for me. I think everything under 20 watts is really great. Over 20 watts is maybe too much. And that's it for today's video. Feel free to subscribe to the channel and give the video a little support by hitting the like button. Thank you very much.